Hello, friends. Stephen Talbot here, and I just started reading a new book. My brother got me the book for Christmas, and it's called Ishmael. Let me just quickly show you what it looks like. So basically, I'm going to start a new playlist for basically, you know, every 4, 5, 6, 7 chapters or every 100 pages or I don't know how often I'll do it. But basically, I'm going to be reviewing the book or the various books that I read and do those like in a new series. And so what would be really cool is maybe you guys would like to read along with me. So here's the book. I've just started. I've only read the first like 70 pages or so. It's called Ishmael. Here's what it looks like. It's by Daniel Quinn. My brother swears by this book. He actually got it for me, and he got it for his daughter, my little niece, as well. That a lot of professors make their philosophy students read it, or their what's the other thing? What's the study of social or the social or the study of social human interaction? Philanthropy, not philanthropy. Shit, I can't think of what I'm trying to say, or I can't think of the word. But anyway, a lot of college professors make their first year students read it. So I really wasn't quite sure what it was about at first. There's some excellent reviews on YouTube from people who are sort of summarizing the entire book. I did watch one of those, and, and I've read a lot of Amazon reviews. The book comes really highly recommended. And so I've just gone through, I'm on chapter, hold up and wait a minute. Gotta put your booty in it. Okay, so I've read the first 3 chapters, and I've just flipped the page to chapter 4. So I'm just going to sort of lay the foundation of the book. And then as I go through several more chapters, I will do another video about sort of just share with you not only what transpired over the pages that I read or read, but also sort of what I think about it. So anyway, what the book, in a nutshell, I think what the book is about, and people, you know, no matter what culture you're in, a lot of people would highly recommend that this is a book, especially in our day and age, that everybody should read. I think where it's going is sort of to make or to question our entire human existence and question the reason why we think the world was made for us to control and for us to consume everything, and sort of, you know, just make us think about the status quo of the way that our society lives on, you know, from every culture across the entire world on every continent. So in the first 4 chapters, I'll just give a quick review or a quick like rundown. When I first started reading this, I was like, okay, this is weird. I really wasn't quite sure. Immediately, the reason I went to the YouTube or to into Amazon to read reviews, oh my God. My picture is broken. That's crazy. Don't know how that happened. Sorry. Anyway, that's crazy. I digress. This is not about my picture, but look, check it out. It's totally cracked. And I love that picture. Okay. Anyway, when I first started reading this, I was like, wanted to call my brother and be like, dude, what is this book even about? I don't think I'm going to be interested in this book. So basically, a guy, when he was younger, he was really part of the 60s culture, the counterculture movement. And as he got older, you know, and when he was younger, he sort of wanted to change the world. And the character I'm talking about is the narrator of the book. He's not named so far, at least. But he is the narrator, and he sees an ad in a newspaper that says, teacher seeks pupil, must be willing to save the world, apply in person. Okay. And when he first reads the ad, he's really pissed off about the ad because he thinks it's like some scam or something. And he's like, oh man, it's probably somebody trying to take advantage of people, or it's going to be like some cult leader or something. So he's pissed off at first, and he decides to go down to see what it's all about. And really the reason he's going to see what it's all about is because he wants to give the guy, whoever placed the ad, he wants to give them, that person, a piece of his mind for like trying to scam people. So he goes into like a nondescript office building, and he walks in, and it's sort of, it's like an empty room, but there's like a stench in the room, and it's pretty much empty, totally empty, blank walls. There's like windows overlooking an alley in the back and some sunshine coming through. Then he notices, and it's like a big open room. It's like where an office has been subdivided. All the walls have been knocked down, and it's been made like a one big room. And then at first he's like, what the hell? There's nobody here. There's nobody present. There's no signs. There's no reception desk. There's nothing. So he walks on back, and he notices that there's like a two-way window or two-way mirror or some kind of either an internal, either a mirror that is looking into another room or like a two-way mirror or something. I can't, I don't know. It's one of those two. Like, it's just a glass, like black glass or some shit. So he sort of peers through, and he doesn't really see anybody. And then he's like startled because he sees eyes looking back at him. And he's kind of like jumps back, and he's kind of like, what the hell? And he doesn't know, quite know what it is at first. Well, then he gets to look in, and there's like a sign in the back that says something about gorillas leaving the world or gorillas being, I forgot, something, some sign about gorillas. Anyway, it ends up being a giant gorilla, like an actual gorilla. And he's like, what the hell is a gorilla doing here? You know, gorillas are really big. And so at first he's like startled. He's like, oh God, I better get out of here. This gorilla could like literally just tap the glass, and the power of the gorilla, just the sheer power, not that the gorilla is like, you know, trying to harm anybody or like a wild beast or anything, but just the mere power of the gorilla itself could like, you know, tap the glass and it would just shatter everywhere, you know? But then he notices that the gorilla is just like sitting there chilling, eating like this branch or whatever. So he is like, what in the world? There's nobody here. There's just a gorilla in a room. This makes no sense. Well, then, and this is where it gets really weird, and this is sort of the part the hump that I sort of had to get over to continue on with the book. Then he says, then the gorilla starts to talk to him telepathically, like intelligently talk to him telepathically. And he basically learns that the gorilla is the teacher, and the gorilla is who placed the ad. So basically, the gorilla is going to be the teacher, and this narrator who has no name is going to be the pupil or the student. So he just starts asking him questions, and sort of that seems to be the style of the book so far, is basically they sort of lead you along a path, and the gorilla's name, by the way, is Ishmael. And so the gorilla explains to the narrator, you know, how he came from Africa and how he used to be in the wild, and then he got captured and went to a zoo, and then he went from the zoo, and then he went to someone sort of saved him and like took him out on this private land, and then he started he learned how to communicate, and the guy taught him everything he knew. Then the gorilla or Ishmael starts asking the narrator questions about evolution, and starts saying, you know, what is the story that every human being knows to be the evolutionary process and how the world came to be? And he sort of said, the gorilla tells him, you know, well, you know, it's a myth. Like, what do you think about mythology? And then they talk about Greek gods and stuff like that. And then the Ishmael says, basically, well, isn't our entire evolution, the entire story of evolution, is it not a myth? Like, who said, like, one day there were some amoebas in the ocean, and then one day there's like human beings, and that was just the end of creation? That was just the end, you know. Even if you think about it from a divine perspective, and if you believe in God, or you believe in like a intelligent design or whatever, it's like the whole point of creation, whether it's evolutionary or whether it's like in the book of Genesis in the Bible, it's like the means to an end was human life. But does that really make sense? And so that's, I'm at a stopping point in the book. That's where really where I'm at now. Ishmael basically can, you know, batters the narrator and keeps asking him, like, does it really make sense that we are the end? Like, the whole process just stopped. The Big Bang happened, and then boom, 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 planets everywhere, and then boom, 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 stars, and boom, 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 sun, and then, you know, the big seas were everywhere, and dinosaurs, and, like, all this stuff. And then 10,000 years ago, there were humans, and then everything just stopped because it was all us, the entire purpose of everything. The whole world just stopped. The evolutionary process just stopped because, man, we're here. And that's all that matters, because we are, you know, the divine beings of the earth, and we control everything, and everything's about us. And so anyway, that's where I'm at in the book. I've been going for 2 minutes, so yeah. So I'm definitely interested. I've been reading the book for a couple hours. I can't put it down. I am about to, actually, I might read a couple more chapters. I don't know. Anyway, that's where I'm at so far. So my first impression, again, you sort of have to get over the hurdle of a telepathic gorilla talking to some man, that, you know, some gorilla who put an ad in the paper. It piqued my interest at first. The first few pages of the book piqued my interest. And then once I learned that the gorilla was communicating telepathically, I literally stopped reading, watched a couple of YouTube video reviews, and then went and read a bunch of reviews on Amazon. Just to sort of let the people who have rated it positively or who had positively reviewed it talk me into continuing to read the book. Because I was like, this is a little bit out there. Not sure where the book is going, but it's kind of crazy. Anyway, so once I got over that hurdle, it's very good. I want to keep reading it. I've heard that it can be life-changing. Many, many people have said that. So I strongly encourage you to go out and get Ishmael. I'm not sure if it's on Audible or not. It's on Amazon, I'm sure. I'm not sure how much it costs on Amazon. The back of it says $16, but, you know, that's never accurate. I'm sure you can get it on Amazon for less than a dollar, probably. Or a used copy or whatever. Anyway, with that, I'll bid you guys farewell. As always, thank you so much for watching my videos. If you're not subscribed to my channel, please take a second to subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, please let me know in the comments section below. And if you like this video in particular, give me a thumbs up. Also, if you've read this book or you'd like to start reading it and like to have an open discussion about it, or dialogue about it as we read it, maybe we can read it together. So, like I said, I just started it. Go out and get your copy today. Love you guys. Talk to you soon. Enjoy yourself.